Well, Flavio, a year ago, you were in qualifying, lost in the second round of qualifying. Here, 12 months later, you're in the third round, preparing to play a night match on Arthur Ashe Stadium. How pleased are you with the progress you've made in the last year?
I'm really happy about my progress for all the year. I think I did a great work with the team, so now I believe in myself. I just want to play tennis, so I think the work is not done, so we will see what happens tonight.
What are going to be the keys for success for you tonight in order to get the win?
I didn't talk with the team for the taxi. I just want to enjoy every point I will do in on the court, joking with the crowd and play my game. So I'm focused on me and I believe in myself, so I'm ready.
Best of luck to you tonight. I'm sure there's a lot of Italian fans out there waiting on you. Well, Daniil, you're preparing for your first night match, or your first match at all here on Arthur Ashe Stadium, a court that is so special to you. How excited are you to get back out here to this familiar court?
Super excited. Don't know how many people are there, but super excited to come back there. I usually play my best tennis there, so looking forward, and hopefully I can show some beautiful tennis.
You know, in a tournament in which there are a lot of upsets, how difficult is it for you, one of the odds-on favorites now, to be able to keep your focus and focus on each match one at a time?
I think, in a way, upsets maybe can even help sometimes because that's where you see the tennis. Anyone can win, you know better than me. On a given match, so you need to give your best, show your best tennis match in, match out to win a Grand Slam. So that's what I'm going to try to do.
Best of luck, Daniil.
Arthur Ashe Stadium, here we go. Please welcome the players for tonight's third round match. From Italy, Flavio Caboli. US Open champion, Daniil Medvedev. For tonight's third round match is John Blum from Australia.
This weekend, and then of course the finals. Maybe let him do the match. He looks best for it. Hey Daniil.
How are you?
Good, good. This is Steve.
How are you doing? It's good to meet you.
Yeah.
Guys,
I just want to do the photos first with Steve. So if we face this way, you know, yeah. Do you want me to take that?
Sorry.
Take that.
Thanks a lot.
So we do it that way with Steve, and then we're going to face that way, and it's just two players. Maybe they don't need it. All right. For the towel boxes, look, you're wearing white. You take the white one. And he's basically wearing red. So you take the red one for the towel boxes, okay? And remember, we have the VR system here. So for not-ups or touch on the net or anything unusual, you can request a challenge on that. The final thing I want to say is, like, there's going to be a bit of movement, more than maybe you're used to. Just try and deal with it. I'm not supposed to say anything, so don't look at me and expect me to say something.
Behind the players?
But on the even games, yes. All right. So at 1-all, 2-all, these games, there are going to be people coming in. I don't mind you to wait. I'm not going to be too heavy-handed, but just be aware it's going to happen. Any questions, Slavia? All good. All right. Steve's going to do the coin toss. We have heads or tails up to you. Right. Who would you like? That's heads, yeah. You receive. Good match. Thanks, Lieutenant General.
Second night match. Daniil Medvedev has been here many times. He's a fine hardcore player. He's playing a guy in Flavio Cribolli. Look, he's seeded 31 here, Jan Michael. Last year he lost in the first round of qualifying. What, and I know how much you love watching Cribolli play. What is it that's gotten him to this stage? Look, fighting for a spot in the fourth round.
Pretty amazing stuff. He's just among this group of up-and-coming, and some, by the way, number one in the world, Italian players that are just pushing each other to great heights. He's really just come out of nowhere this year. I was like, who is this kid playing earlier in the year, and just plays with such intensity. He does kind of play a little bit more of an all-court game. You'll see him come forward a little bit, great from the baseline. He's fast, has some variety in his game, but not afraid to also come forward to the net, which he'll need to do, by the way, against Medvedev. The octopus will take him out otherwise. He has no chance. Very difficult to put the ball by Medvedev. A little look at the grounds here.
I mean, he's only 22 years old, this Italian guy has never played in an atmosphere like this Saturday night.
Absolutely.
Ash, I mean, 24,000 people watching. Let's see how he handles all that. Although, this is what he's dreamed of. This is what he's always talked about. He says, I want the people to know about my name when I stop playing.
Love that.
I thought I did too. He says, so I want to be an important player on the court, but also outside. I want to always smile, always try to have fun with the sport. So, of course, I want to win a big tournament, he says. But the first thing is for people to know about me after my career. This guy's got big dreams.
3 minutes. 3 minutes.
I like that he says he wants people to know about it, but he's not really giving a specific result. He just wants to have fun and compete. That's sort of an amazing thing to say. He seems very likable. It's just a good attitude. So easy to kind of get behind him and root him on. A lot of people really enjoy his tennis.
A lot of people enjoy this man's set. The octopus.
I mean, he seems like he has more than two hands to me. He finds ways to put balls back in the court. He hits shots that no one else hits. No one else plays like Medvedev. It's beyond me, Mary, as to how he can hit the ball so flat from so far back in the court. We'll see him back there by his name on that board pretty often.
He has never faced Cribolli. He's never even practiced with him. So this will be a bit of a learning experience for the 2021 champ. There should be some nice high energy.
2 minutes, 2 minutes.
Best recent result, of course, for Medi is semifinals, I would say, at Wimbledon. Another great result from him. Round of 16 at Roland Garros this year. And of course, that final to begin the year in Australia. I don't believe, Mary, that he's won a title this year. I think it's since Rome last year that he won a title.
He's the only man in the top 10 without a title in 2024.
Only man left in this event who's won it. Pretty interesting. Is the pressure
on him now? 1 minute.
I think so. I mean, we saw how well he played in 2021. He's had some scratchy results of late, right? Coming up into this tournament, he didn't have good results, right?
Yeah, not great in Canada or Cincinnati. Lost to Davidovich Fokina in Canada and Yuri Lehechka, who plays a big ball in Cincinnati. Bit of a surprise.
30 seconds.
Do a little bit better if you check out his coach, the box there.
Gilles Simon was in his box as well. He was there the other night too.
That guy knows a thing or two about tennis. Fantastic career he had, just recently retired.
Wow, a lot of Italians are here to watch this. I mean, Italy's fans have been going crazy this year, right? Yeah, Nick Sinner with the Australian. And a very tough
and prepared to play.
On the women's side, getting to the French Open final, the Wimbledon final, winning Olympic gold in doubles with Sara Errani. Jasmine Paolini still alive on the women's side.
Paolini hadn't really won any matches here before in the past. And just won one match on the hard courts here. And now contending, perhaps, to go very deep in this set as well, Paolini. What a breath of fresh air. It's so much fun to watch.
Yeah. Lorenzo Musetti, another Italian, who's had a very good look in 2024.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Cavalli won the toss and elected to receive in the first game.
I did a match of Medvedev's the other
ready
night.
Ready for play.
He had trouble.
First set, Daniil Medvedev to serve.
Had a bunch of double faults. Let's see if he straightened that out.
Yes, Mary, I've covered several of Medvedev's matches this year, and the serve hasn't been as good this year as in the past. Now, that's not the case in all his matches, but there has been some issues where their double faults have been tricky for him. See if that's a factor today or not.
Cavalli's calf is really wrapped.
30 love.
He's a quick guy, so hopefully it's not too serious.
Right, exactly. The speed's very much a part of his game. If he's not able to move out there, well, he does have that wrapping on there. Hopefully that's precautionary or to keep the pressure on it. Remember, he tweaked. Easy to do that at the end of the year.
Showman, isn't he?
He's a showman.
13-15.
You might expect that from an Italian player.
Yeah, he just decides that's a good time to hit a winner. That's good.
Oh, well, he was inside the baseline. Might as well go for something. Fresh off a final in Washington, D.C. He lost to Sebastian Corda, ATP 500 level event there. Been winning matches in a lot of the tournaments that he's entered. That includes on grass as well, quarterfinals at Eastbourne.
Game Medvedev. First game.
lies the last 15.
Volley versus Medvedev. How consistent will he be? How many unforced errors will he cough up like that last one? Just overplaying a little bit. This is what Medi does to his opponents. Makes them overplay. Look how big the court looks on his side. These two playing, is that more favorable for Medi or for Caboli? Feels like it's more favorable for Daniil.
Well, Caboli's seen Daniil play a lot more than the other way.
It's true, he's seen him play, but out there on the court, they haven't even practiced, as we mentioned. Playing players that far back is so tricky with your mind. Weakness on the backhand
15
is the weapon.
13.
Do some damage with the backhand, especially an approach shot if he has to hit it.
He likes
does,
the net
does
too.
Does all right. He'll come forward. I think that's got to be a component in today's matchup. Have to come forward a little bit. Not many players can take on Medvedev from the baseline and effectively beat him from just staying back. From Medi, just a little too high. Got what it deserved. That's a nice volley.
Love 15.
It's a pretty heavy forehand that Caboli is able to create with that spin. Might be, if he can do it well enough, just out of the strike zone of Medvedev. Maybe he can draw some errors.
15-0.
Dynamic movement and stroke production there. It's an explosive ball that comes off that racket.
Oh. his father throwing that.
That looks choreographed, all three at the same time.
Yeah.
A little bit. 31 shots in that exchange, and Medvedev ready for some applause. Get this crowd involved. Well, that'll test your lungs a little bit.
I know it's there as well.
Thank you for the backdrop, please. Waiting for you. Thank you.
The screens can, the players at times when they're still going as they're trying to start the next point. You'll hear them complain.
Oh, good luck seeing the ball against that screen.
Yeah, exactly. His dad, Stefano, who played in the on the ATP tour as well, got to 236 in the rankings. But his dad wasn't always his coach. He only started working when Cavoli was 17 years old.
Yes.
His dad always said to him, you have to improve alone. You have to make your life alone, and then I will help you later.
It's a unique perspective.
I know.
It's an unusual perspective as well.
His dad said to him, I'd like to make this work so I can help you later when you're ready. Big blue eyes, just like his son's.
Oh.
Does it take a guy like Medvedev, who's so smart?
It might take him a set or two.
Really?
It might. I was impressed with that last game. Cavoli was really consistent in some of those rallies.
15 love.
The long one that Medvedev won, they were both just testing each other out, like almost like boxers going at it in the middle. And Medvedev won the rally, but I felt like Cavoli learned something there. And then you saw him sort of take some shots just in the middle of the court, resetting often during the rallies before going bigger. He's adapting.
Yes. 15-1.
doesn't want to play longer points against Medvedev, right?
This kid wants to break open the rallies as soon as he sees something he can go with.
I think a blend of both, Mary, is what he needs to do. A few long rallies isn't going to hurt him. Ooh, that's a scary
15-30.
But isn't Medvedev a lover of the long rallies?
Yeah, he's a lover of the long rallies, but if you can beat him in a couple of long rallies, that sends a message to Medvedev. And of course, this Kaboli has the firepower to really hurt you if you give him a ball in the middle of the court.
Got it.
I don't know what's going on with his serve here in this game. It hasn't looked as good as in the first game. Through that rally, Danil had a chance to come forward, refused to approach. It's a pretty short ball. So great when he has a target. He's so great that far back, able to hit the ball in just these precise locations. Look at that. Risky, all the things you would not teach a youngster to do. Danil does. Oh, so well. It's a great shot. A little applause from Kaboli as well.
Two games all for sets.
And USOpen.org can catch you up on everything that's been happening, not just for the tournament, but right now. Let's see what's going on.
It's 59.
And Dan Evans, they're having some battle. Divinor taking the first, Evans the second in a tiebreak. Divinor up a break in the third. Catch up with that one. That's so nice. Oh, man, that's nice.
Kaboli
showing off his shot making prowess. A beautiful lob there. I think he lost track of the plot a little bit in that last game. His serve was out of sync. Couldn't imagine he's thinking about the score already, but he did have that break that may have affected him a little. Therein lies the issue when you're playing against Medvedev. You can't just force your way into the net. really have to set the point up or get him on the run, see the ball floating, then come in, maybe as a sneak volley.
40-15. Mr. Medvedev is asking to see a replay of the call on the right near sideline, please.
I thought he had missed it.
What's that?
I thought Cavani's shot missed.
Now Svorshuk was in. Medvedev just missed it. Like what I've seen from Kaboli already, I'm returning. He's moving around where he's receiving serve. He's trying different things. Oh. Saw him way back in the previous one. Here he is backing up again on the second serve. This is right out of the page of Medvedev.
Medvedev leads by 3-2. Love 15.
Flavio can't afford to do is make these sort of first ball errors. It's going to be a tough night if he has to fight out of these kinds of games often. There's Medi back there right by the wall. I'm not sure how he's able to play that far back, but here he is again. Just can't imagine what a nightmare he would have been to play against.
Turns it.
Love 40.
Jim Michael, but then he takes back the court, doesn't he?
He does come. He comes up quick. If you give him anything, he gets up there and he hits through the ball. The thing that it just boggles my mind every time I watch him play is how deep he can get the ball as flat as he hits it from that far back. I understand how Casper Ruud does it. I understand how Kaboli's done it. Even in this match, he's backed up and hit some pretty deep balls with spin.
Right.
Rafa, I get it. Medvedev, I don't get it.
Medvedev leads 4-2 for sets.
I totally get all the tactics, the strat, all of those things, but how do you learn to do that from that far back? That's impressive stuff. Easy break.
15 love.
Remember, Medvedev was down a break, not for very long.
30 love.
Mary, you mentioned the serve issues that he's had in some of his matches, not all this year, and none today so far. 62% on that first serve, notable faults and an ace to go along with it. Well, this is the kind of tennis that we do expect from Daniil Medvedev here at the US Open.
game. Medvedev.
Better temperament too.
New balls, please. Medvedev leads 5-2 first set.
Kubaly serving here to stay in the first set.
Love 15.
That was quite the kick serve, Mary Carillo. 69 miles an hour is all it was, but it was all the way almost off the court. Got his
15-13.
It's too many long. Definitely needs some Forza in there. Whole mix of Forza. Last few games have flown by.
Some
set points for the fifth seed. The only player left in the men's draw who's won this.
Feels like a little bit in the latter part of the set, Klavyuch is trying to figure out what his strategy is. Am I going big in the ground strokes? Am I trying to come in? This time offered up a passing shot, so there's no other choice but to go for it. It's a good shot.
Juice.
See so many players overplaying against Medvedev because he's so far back, returning on his own serve, he's closer, but he's returning, so they overplay on the baseline. Seen a lot of that so far.
Advantage Medvedev.
He must really change his opponent's sight lines being that far back, right?
Absolutely. I don't think there's anybody doing that when I was playing. Not to that extent. Not on a hard court. Favors the
Jews.
Did hear that drop shot. Important hold here, really. If you can hold, make Medvedev serve it out, then at least start serving in the next set.
Advantage, Kubaly. Kobole. Medvedev leads 5-3 for set.
Flavio deciding to keep the racket for the new ball game and then switching it out here, returning.
Second.
Another one down.
30 love.
Well, this looks like Medvedev of old as far as his service is concerned. That's guy who won this tournament in 2021, finalist in 23. Great results here at the Open.
40 love.
Set now on the first serve.
The shot that had been bothering him has been a real, real good shot tonight.
Unforced errors.
Kobole to serve.
Of the mix here, 10 of them from Kobole hurt him, especially in the end of the set. And he's serving down at 42%. That percentage has to come up in this second set here.
Love 15. Love 13.
Seen some nice variety from Mehdi today. Serve locked in. It's a good drop shot there. He's playing with some depth.
I think he's trying to run this kid.
Absolutely.
Take out his legs,
see if he has some feel coming forward.
Love 14.
Wants to see where that ball landed. I do too. It was pretty close. Just kidding. We don't get to see it. Love 40. Kind of a tattoo he was going to get in New York.
He doesn't know.
Leaves it up to inspiration.
He's pretty whimsical about the
whole thing. Yeah, it seems like it.
30-14.
It feels like it's necessary for him to win a few points like this one. Stay in the rally. Finally got the shot that he really wanted to lay into. Look at it hit through that one. Flatten it out a little bit. Surprised Medvedev there.
Yes.
All of a sudden, this game has gotten complicated for Medvedev.
Great backhand. There's two of them this game. Just really well placed cross court. Didn't go for too much. Didn't go for the line on either of those backhands. What a battle.
Second serves.
Found a way to hold.
Love 15.
Aces Medvedev, that's his first double fault.
Good strike on that forehand from Medvedev. Got some more depth and pace on it. Clavio just caught it a little bit late. On all surfaces these days, you hurt your opponent, see them floating the ball, and you're all over the net, blocking that away. Nice play from Medvedev. Consider that message sent. He left home early on that return, got around it, and absolutely crushed it. Setting up the put away.
40-13. Second sets.
Another drop shot there. Didn't quite pay off. It's tough. You see Medvedev all the way back. That front part of the court does look open, but Daniil Medvedev is not slow coming forward. Got there with plenty of time.
And still Medvedev stays that far back, Jim Michael.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, you know, I'll give you your winners. I'll give you your forehands. Just gonna ride you out.
Second time in this match, serving volley there.
30 love.
On that backhand, he didn't get the spin he needed that we've seen so often.
Sorry, Jim. I got how many 3 out of 5 set matches has Flavio Cavoli played?
Good question. Oh. Only 6-4 at slams so far.
Okay.
So, 10.
So he's being challenged on
30-40.
Medvedev is trying to take his legs out, and he knows he's got to win three more sets tonight.
It's a lot. He's got a little calf issue.
Yeah, exactly.
As well. Took him four sets in both the previous matches, so he's played a little bit of tennis as far as this week is concerned. Both against James Duckworth and another up-and-coming player, Zizou Bergs.
Game Medvedev. Medvedev leads by 2-1. Second set, 1-0.
Last couple of sets, Dimitrov just shut down Evans, but keep in mind that Evans to get past the 23 seed Karapatchanov. Win five sets, including three tiebreaks. More than 5 hours on the court.
5:35,
I believe. Is that what it was?
Yeah, 5:35.
Wow.
That could have taken some of the starch out of old Dan.
I would imagine.
But then he had beaten Navone quickly.
We're seeing a little bit of what we saw witnessed in the first set. Medvedev completely locking in midway through. We're not quite midway through yet. Might get there in a hurry. There was a bunch of games that were at love in a row for Medvedev. Broke, then held at love. It's a tough game on serve in the last one. Remember, Caboli had to come back in the very first game of this set from love 40. Battled there.
40 love.
Medi, for the most part, holding pretty easily.
Medvedev leads 3-1, second sets.
Another reminder that USOpen.org can catch you up on your favorite players, your scores, highlights. It's on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, Facebook, WhatsApp. Tell you what's happening.
Yes. 15 love.
Trying to breathe some life into Caboli. I can't believe he missed that return. It was awful close. You gotta be kidding me. That's a crazy
15-all.
Tape, the Kinesio tape, that right calf.
Thirty, 15. 40-15. Said one set to love.
Flavio Caboli, every bit of this is new to him.
15 love.
Feels like he'll do a lot of learning in tonight's match.
He lost in first round qualies here last year, and he's a seed 1 year later. That's some fun.
Side-to-side action from Medvedev. That's a strategy we'll often see from Daniil. He's keeping his opponent moving.
40 love.
Stat in the corner there, if you, your eyes could catch it, it hasn't lost his point on his first serve in this set, Medvedev. That gives you a lot of confidence.
That's so true.
Game, Medvedev. Medvedev leads 4-2, 2 seconds.
That's so much more assured than he's looked. Not just earlier in the week, but for the whole hardcourt season.
Yeah, it's much better. I agree, much, much better.
Let's for sure.
With Djokovic already out, Alcaraz already out.
Yeah, maybe he's thinking, hey, I don't have to beat him this time.
I don't have to go through those guys.
Now these guys have to beat me. Center's still out there, lurking.
He won the first hardcourt major of the year in Melbourne. You know what he can do in this.
15 love.
Guess who Sinner beat in that final?
I remember.
Medvedev.
What a comeback. What was the score?
30-love.
Remind me.
6-3, 6-3 for Medvedev, and 6-4, 6-4, and 6-3 for Sinner. The great comeback. Two sets to love. Pretty straightforward first couple of sets for Medi. Flavio overusing the drop shot for my taste. Think about Daniil. He'll give you a couple of these, but he starts to look for it. He's so precise.
He starts to resent it.
Yeah. How dare you drop shot me? I know that whole front part of the court's open. Oh. Forehand to finish that point off. That's a lot of work. See if he has any more wind in his lungs.
See, that's the problem, John Michael. It's only worth 1 point, all that effort. Trying to do everything.
Medvedev leads 4 games to 3, second set, and by 1 set to love. This ball is soft. The point just played will stand. However, we will replace this ball. Thank you.
You know what's happened sometimes? The women use a different ball. And sometimes the ball can find something behind.
Yeah. That's all good. We got enough.
The men using the heavy duty balls.
True. Yeah, different balls. That's possible. Shouldn't be happening on the main stadium, but
no. It's been it happens every now and then.
Stuff happens. Especially with all the different events that go on in between matches and things like that. There can be something left out there that you're hidden in one of the corners.
Thank you. Give those out.
John Blom doing a good job. Regulating his court.
Love 15.
So how many balls got switched out there?
They might have just switched them all out.
People here have never heard of this kid.
Exactly. Interesting.
Please.
They want him to break there.
Yeah.
Love 14.
There's the double faults that we were talking about earlier. Beginning of this match, it has been an issue with Medvedev this year. Two in a row.
3 and 4.
That's tough.
No!
15-14.
I mean, really, Danilo has been so locked in this match. This is the first time he's sort of wavered.
Yeah. 30-14.
Serve, I guess, finally he found it.
Even Gilles Cervara has to let.
How could you not? It's great entertainment. How did he come back from 140 there? What a weird game. Two double faults in a row and then just turn it on.
Yeah. Loved everything.
All right.
Love 15.
Stop with the drop shots, Fabio. Knows it. Unforced air discrepancy. More from Medvedev.
Yeah, he's the guy at 5-3.
Love 13.
Besides that double right there, it's been pretty clean set for Kabuli. 6 unforced errors, 4 winners. Medvedev just being more offensive with 12 winners and, of course, some of those aces. 13 unforced errors. At 5-3, there's been a lot of tough rallies.
What do you mean? A couple of bailout drop shots.
Yeah, exactly.
That's a tell, right?
15-14.
I just feel like sometimes the shot selection for him, he doesn't know what to do against Medvedev, where against other players, he probably might try something different. The drop shot might even work. Do that. I need a few more of those.
Set to love.
Had some chances in the last game. Sliding around like that. What is he on, an ice rink? How does he do that? Great forehands from Gaboli.
Error.
serve percentage has dipped a little bit here for Mehdi. Down below 50% in this set.
Third duel.
Certainly is a difference when he lands the first serve. Only lost 2 points on first serve in this set. 14 for 16.
Sets to love.
Well, he's played a real good looking match and he's still down 2 sets to love.
Couple games, all of a sudden, Gabolli going bigger on the serve. He's hitting in the 120s more often. He's not kicking as much. Could be a sign that he's a little bit weary from all the running, the big hitting that he's done. Or it could be a strategy, or maybe a mix of both. With that serve and volley attempt.
It's an 83 mile an hour serve with no real intention.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it looked like.
Something, which of Medvedev's strokes is the most normal?
The backhand. I think the backhand is the most normal. Even that overhead is a bit of a sidewinder. He hit the ball differently than pretty much anybody else inside of the ball on that. I guess on purpose. It was perfect.
More heat on these serves.
Fifteen all.
Return. I think he got caught in a grip that he didn't want, so he had to block it. Got some underspin on it. It's easy to miss against an underspin ball if you're trying to hit some topspin. Don't get enough on it.
Oh, boy.
Game to volley.
Good break.
Four volley leads to game to love third sets.
Double fault. That's how that one ended.
That's interesting. Gaboli goes a little bit bigger on his serve last couple of games. There hasn't been as many long exchanges. Maybe Medvedev loses a little rhythm, which he likes.
Love 15.
Bit of brickage on that volley. He thought it was going to come back that fast. Three out of five set matches, so difficult to play that many sets in a row. Often it's the third set. It's a little bit of a lull.
Let's for sure.
Seems like even a great player like Medvedev is having one here.
Said earlier, Jim, like Medvedev really likes a rhythm. He likes to have his kind of points. Gaboli keeps breaking them open.
Exactly. It's pretty brilliant. It's a different strategy. Whether it is because he's feeling the lungs a little, or he just decided, or good coaching. Remember, there's coaching nowadays.
30-14.
He was maybe just fed up and decided to start doing that. I guess I do wonder if he knows that that's what's going on and that it's sort of affected Medi. Facing a break point here.
Oh.
expensive. The volley leads by 2-1 third set. Medvedev by 2 sets to love.
In this match against this hot shot kid, hasn't gotten frustrated. Hasn't panicked.
15-love.
Mentioned just a little bit of a lull, and he had one in the third set. He seemed to have set things right pretty quickly. Could have been 3-0. Into the body too much, caught it way late, had a good intention on it, get a forehand, be offensive.
Game Medvedev, 2-all.
Well, you think about how much this man's improved in the last year. How much can he improve in another year? Really has a lot of tools that are exceptional. It's good speed, the way he competes in his matches. Big forehand. We've seen him hit some big serves. Good variety in the serves. It's come forward effectively against a guy who's really difficult to get up there and do anything with the net. I guess next 40, big 30. To find a way and start to believe that he can beat the top 10 players. He's 0-5 so far against the top 10. Could be 0-6 after this if he can't figure out a way back into this match. Win three sets in a row. So many good things happening to the Italian from all the hard work.
He's landing some blows, beautiful ones, but kind of feels like he's a little punch drunk now.
I think those are perfect words. I think that's exactly what's happening. He's not willing to get in the long exchanges right now. Forehand. It's not a shot you normally see Medvedev miss. Maybe a little bit of that extra spin you see come off the rack at the forehand, especially of Kaboli. Made things a little more difficult for Medi.
Is in play. Thank you.
John's had enough.
This rowdy Saturday night.
I think a lot of people thought that backhand wasn't going to be so great out of the corner from Medvedev. How he got that kind of depth on it. Too much in the line there. You have to give a lot of credit to Medvedev for forcing that testiness and unwillingness to stay in the rallies.
Yes.
How hard he continues to fight.
Same.
He's got to know that he's not going to beat Medvedev, right? And look how hard he's fighting.
It's unlikely. It is unlikely at this juncture of the match, and it's a long, long way back. Think about how much experience he'll generate from this match. And if he didn't put the effort in, learn as much. Sleep in that one. In that last rally to put the ball away, Mary. And just moving him around the court.
Diabolically.
An evil mastermind.
He really, he really is. And that's why we love him.
So good. So good. It's such a great strategy.
Is in the fourth round.
Love 15.
Pretty good lob. It was obvious that that was coming, but you know, just mistimed it.
Bravo, bravo.
Love that aim.
That's a shot that has had some effect on Medvedev. So sort of an off-pace forehand, a little bit heavier, more spin on it. Doesn't give any pace for Medvedev to work with. Needed them. With that return, just left too short. Not sure exactly what he wanted to do with it, but can't give Medi that shot. He is so precise on that backhand. Is so much fun.
Juice.
And then the evil genius does that. Swipe of the ring.
You just had to love the two different personalities that these two guys have, and also their game styles are so different. That's such the beauty of our sport. Can't believe it.
please.
How much money is this kid going to make off the court?
He's going to earn it all. Down. Well, that last game was the slowest the balls will be, right? The end of their life on this court.
On this planet.
Yeah, maybe not on the planet. Hopefully donated to some good cause. There's lots of them out there. But now it speeds up a little bit. That helps Medvedev get a little more pop on it. Takes away a little time maybe from Kapola. We'll see.
Lottery.
This time, forehands. Back in my head, I thought the new balls. Not great. At least for the fans of the Italian, there's a lot of them in this stadium.
Two sets to love.
You are right, Jan Michael. Flavio Caboli is learning an awful lot.
I think he's got to cheer for. Nice person. Don't like his chances against Medvedev. However, in the end.
Yes. 15 love.
First serve percentage in this set's low for Medi. That's one of the reasons he's having a little bit more trouble holding serve. He's at 40%.
Dirty love.
He got broken in. This might have gotten him over the hump that he broke back again. Now he looks more solid in this game.
Okay, that's a shot that you say is his most normal shot.
Yes. That is his most normal. Okay. It's not normal. It's unusual. It's so fun to watch. The strokes are. Hey, how am I going to talk? I had a pretty normal looking backhand, but I had a two-handed forehand. I'm not one to talk.
It's a good shot.
It's a good shot.
Oh. 40-15. Medvedev leads 5-3, third set.
Games ago for Kaboli might have been the last of his major effort, taking a little bit more wind out of the lungs.
Love that him.
The evidence of that is the four forehands missed in the next service game. Pretty easy hold for Medi. Look at that. That's 10 points, 9-1, favoring the fifth seed. Mary, I like it.
I love it.
But give me the positivity all day.
But that energy that he used to break Medvedev ended up breaking him.
Right.
So,
and a little bit of admiration from the Italian as well for what this guy's accomplished in his career and is a whole lot, including right here at the Open. One of the favorites to go all the way, perhaps, here. Think, Maria, before the match, I don't know if we've seen a lot of Caboli play. I told you I was a fan. Looking forward to this, right? I think he's one of the most exciting players to come around for a while. Can't wait to see what he can do in his career, just a young career so far. Look how far he's come in just a year, qualifying last year, first round.
They've got a big hand.
To this, crowd favorite tonight. Really funny, he stole that shoe.
Again, more than anything, I think he's he can get stronger.
He can. More matches like this.
Exactly.
He's gonna do a selfie. That's nice, taking a little time.
You don't want to rush up on this, right?
I agree with you.
It's a beautiful night. Against a terrific opponent with an admiring crowd. Remember what he said. He wants people to remember his name. These people on this court, they'll remember his name.
Daniil, tremendous effort tonight. First time playing Flavio. How long did it take you to kind of really assess his game?
Yeah, I mean, it was a tough match. He was just a little bit up and down, and at one moment started playing much better on my serve than on his. So it was a tricky match, very, very humid, very hot out there. I think that makes the conditions a bit slower because I was watching other matches before mine. I was like, wow, these guys don't attack. There are only rallies. And then I went on court, and it was exactly the same. So, yeah, it is what it is, but happy to win.
All right. Now, when you... Your opponent is asking for a lot of love for the crowd. And that one game, then all of a sudden you started clapping. What is that like when your opponent is doing it, then all of a sudden you're asking for the love?
Honestly, it was fun. It was a tough game. Love 42 double faults. And the crowd wants a break. So then I made like almost three aces or four aces in a row. So I was like, okay, give me some love. And then he came back, amazing point. Then I made like the volley. So it was a lot of fun. It was a fun match to play. The crowd was pretty full, I feel like, for such a late time, and I was enjoying myself.
That's good. Now, how aware were you of the last couple of nights before you walked out here, the couple of monster upsets that we had?
Look, I said it before the match that, you know, on me, upsets don't really matter. The only thing that can make that means the conditions are a bit tricky, so the favorites maybe have less margin against the other guys, and just have to be more cautious, you know. If I play good tennis, I can win the whole thing. If I don't play good, I can lose against anyone, whatever, upset, not upset. So just have to play my best and try to win.
All right, next up for you, you've played a couple of times at Nuno Borges. What are your thoughts on that match?
Yeah, he's a very tough opponent. I played him first in Australian Open, and he surprised me with how much power he has. Very, very like aggressive player, I would say. So not an easy match. I saw him play today. Amazing comeback, three match points down. So looking forward to playing him again.
Moving on, our 2021 champion, Daniil Medvedev.
It was a fun match. It was straight sets, but boy, we sure learned a lot about the 22-year-old from Florence. And we also found out that Daniil Medvedev is playing better with every round, Jan Michael.
He certainly is. He's locked in, and he says that if he plays his best tennis, he could walk out of this beautiful stadium the champion. I agree with him. He played well tonight. He was right. There were some ups and downs with Flavio Caboli. A lot of it, a lot of fun to watch. And it was a lot of fun to watch Daniil Medvedev figure things out tonight.
Exactly.
Get it done in straight sets.
Six-three.